वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स इन आवर नेक्स्ट सीरीज ऑफ बायोलॉजी बाय महेश सर फॉर 12th साइंस. टुडे वी विल टेक पॉलन ग्रेन जर्मिनेशन. द प्रोसेस बाय विच द पॉलन ग्रेन विच लैंड ऑन अ स्टिग्मा. सो इट इज अ साइट वेयर द पॉलन ग्रेन आर प्रोड्यूस एंड देन ट्रांसफर ऑन द स्टिग्मा. द प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड पॉलिनेशन. द नेम ऑफ प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड पॉलिनेशन. आफ्टर द लैंडिंग ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन ऑन द स्टिग्मा they germinate and then develop like this structure so that they can release their two male gamete into the embryo sac. So the process by which pollen grain develop and release the pollen two male gamete into the embryo sac process is called pollen grain germination. So we will first of all discuss the structure of pollen grain. It is a structure of pollen grain where the outer structure is called exine, inner structure called entine, and then the pore where the exine is absent, the pore is called germ pore. Clear? And the two cell, one cell is called vegetative cell, another cell is called germ or germinal cell. So it is a structure of pollen grain. Now in this structure, all the structure involved in this process, first of all, the exine. This exine is called preservative. If pollen grain is unable to germinate, that time exine sustain the pollen grain for long time. So it is a work of exine. Now second, entine, the inner membrane. Clear? It involve in the pollen tube formation. Third is a vegetative cell. The cell, it is also called tube cell, or the nucleus is called tube nucleus. Lower cell is called germinal cell. It responsible for formation of two gamete. It produce two male gamete. The work of these first male gamete and then second male gamete. So it is a work of germinal cell. Now work of germ pore. Here the site where the pollen tubes are formed, you can see that the pollen tube formation site is the germ pore. The exact site is called germ pore, from where pollen tube produce. So it is a work of all different structures which related to the pollen grain. Now we will take the process of pollen grain germination. So first of all, after landing the pollen grain on a stigma, they absorb the nutrient. Which type of nutrient they absorb? First, they absorb water. Second, boric acid. And third, which is very important, sugar. These are the three important nutrients for pollen grain. These three nutrients absorbed by the pollen grain. Now, after the absorption of nutrient by the pollen grain, these pollen grain tube cell increase their size. After the increasing their size of pollen tube or tube cell, they tend to increase their size and move downward. So here the tip region, it contains the tube nucleus. It is tube nucleus. Clear? So these tube nucleus is always follow the complete pollen tube. These tube nucleus is here, clear, in the vegetative cell. So it tend to increase the size of pollen tube. Now after the formation of these pollen tube, from in one step a short size, after then a middle size, and then long size. These sizes depend on size of style and then the distance of pollen, distance of embryo sac. So it is a pollen tube. Now after then, we can say that it is, the structure is called tube nucleus. Now after the formation of complete structure of pollen tube, the generative cell divide, these generative cell divide and produce two male gamete. These are the two male gamete. First male gamete and here the second male gamete. So these two male gamete now release into the pollen tube. Now these are the first step where it is a pollen grain. Here the size, here the area which is called germs area. Now in germinal area where the tube nucleus is enlarges. Now due to this enlarges, it start to increase the size. Now these tube nucleus or tube cell increase their long tube and then convert into the this structure. After the development of these long tube, the germ cell divide and release the two male gamete. These two male gamete travel by the tube cell. Now these process is called pollen grain germination. Now we can see the diagram of these, where the long pollen tube travel from the stigma and run through the style. Here the region is a style, and then it enter into the embryo sac. It is embryo sac. Now in embryo sac, the upper structure is antipodal cell. Now center cell is called secondary nucleus. These cell or these structure is called egg cell. And the lower cell is called synergid cell. These synergid cell contain the long fiber-like long finger-like structure. These structure is called filiferous apparatus. These filiferous apparatus move these pollen tube into the embryo sac. Now these pollen tube contain the two male gamete. Now it is the first male gamete and it is the second male gamete. So these two male gamete enter into the embryo sac, from where the first male gamete fuse with the egg cell and then produce zygote, and then second male gamete fuse with the polar cell and then produce primary endosperm nucleus. So it is a complete process is called pollen grain germination. We can say starting pollen grain germination means the process by which pollen grain which land on the stigma develop into this type of structure for target or main object for pollen grain germination. It transport the two male gamete into the embryo sac. It start from here, then travel these journey in which the rounded structure and then short tube structure, long middle tube and then long tube structure. And the work of these tube formation performed by the vegetative cell or tube cell. Clear? Generative cell work, it produces two germ cell or two male gamete. Clear? It produces two male gamete. Function of these two male gamete, first male gamete fuse with the egg cell. Here it is egg cell, produce a zygote, and these zygote further develop into the embryo. And then embryo develop into the seed. And second nucleus fuse with the polar cell and then produce a primary endosperm nucleus. These primary endosperm nucleus provide nutrition to developing embryo. So it is the process of pollen grain germination. Thank you for watching my video for 12th class. In next class, I will provide double fertilization.